Hi, I'm Cyaneink, and today I'm answering one question I get quite a lot asked. How many fan members I have? This is three-part series. So let me explain something. I have a lot. First, and this will be like tour of my fan members. I will show all my like modern ones, then go to vintage ones that are working condition. Then the last part will be all the vintage ones that aren't working. So let's get started. I'll try to like group this up a little bit. And first ones are Lamy Safaris and also Vista, which is also like same pin. This is the limited edition a couple years back. Of course I had to get it because it's lime neon green color. This one has broad nib. I use this because the ink that came with this edition is really, really bright, almost like highlighter. It works better with the like broad nib. And this has extra fine, which is more like my liking. And also this Vista has broad nib because I use often my like those shimmering colors in this Vista. And they works better with like broad nibs. So these are my two Lamy Safaris and Vista. And yeah, I have two Lamy Safaris that are same color because I like it so much. Yep. Let's continue. Then there is my TWSBI's. My workhorse pen still, and it has been for longest time, has been TWSBI Diamond 580. And this has extra fine nib. If you don't know, I really like extra fine nibs. This is often Sailor Kiwakura pigment ink. I have written many like exams with this ink. Every important paper I use this pen, so it's like my workhorse pen. Then Vac 700, also one of my favorite pens. It's large, has vacuumatic filling system. This has coordinated gray ink. It is extra fine. This is the new improved R version. Then TWSBI Eco, which has extra fine nib in it. It has custom nib. And this is the lime color. And I'm getting the neon one really soon. It's actually, I'm not yet ordered it, but I will order it so soon. But it didn't make in this review. Then there's my two Pelikans, two modern Pelikans. I have some vintage ones. And that was TWSBI. I have too many pens here. Where should I put this? Put them there. And this is Pelikan M205 Duo, which is the highlighter version. It came with the broad nib, and I don't like broad, so I ordered the extra fine one. And this is piston filler, in green color, of course. And this is my newest fountain pen. It's Pelikan Twist, and you can see the color going here. It is actually meant for children, but it's really nice to hold. And this has fine nib because extra fine was not available. It was only fine and medium, so I got the finest one. I've been really liking both of these. And this one is actually one of my like my I don't have like super expensive pens, but this is like one of the expensive ones. Then my only pilot, which is Pilot Vanishing Point. And for longest time I really struggle with to get this pen or not, because it's really because in Europe Pilot Vanishing Point comes only in fine point, and that wasn't like enough for me. I wanted to extra fine, and often it was only just a medium. And when I see this color, I really wanted to get this color in fine, and because extra fine isn't available, it has black nib, which I really like. First I was getting the whole black version, but when I see this green one, I really wanted this. This was really hard to get. I ordered this. It's the only pen that this came from overseas. And I ordered this from overseas. And this is my most expensive pen. And also because the price is $115, I think, plus value-added tax or what, and customs. So it was really expensive, but I love it and I will love it forever. I have been thinking to get like the extra fine nib unit here, but the fine is really fine, so I think that's enough for me. And this is Platinum Century 3776, which is really pretty black pen. I like because it looks so much like the vintage pens. And this has ultra extra fine nib because it was like the finest nib available. And this is cartridge converter pen. Currently it has cartridge. It has so fine nib that this cartridge like seems like never ending. I have been really loving this pen. I like this so a lot that I really want to try the other color as well. Then, Caran 849. And this is Phantom. This has extra fine nib. And this is regular cartridge converter pen. Currently have empty cartridge there. And of course I got this because the color, you haven't yet noticed, I really love this bright green, so I really had to get this one. I was like thinking like in the green one or this yellow one, but this yellow one is actually closer to the color I like. Then my first fountain pen. Yeah, this is the first one of them all. And I think that's the only reason why it's still in my collection. This is Parker Urban, the older version, which has this nice tapered going on. It has currently converter and I use red ink there. This is full metal pen, so it's really heavy. And it's not that good writer either. It has only fine nib because there wasn't extra fine available. It's rightly dry, it's not that like great, but it's my first fountain pen and I have like, it has some sentimental value. I will keep this. And I also like all black pens, and I think this is like my only all black pen currently. Then Fountain Pen Revolution Indus, which has flex nib. It's piston filler, inexpensive piston filler from India. And as you can see here, it just actually leaked in the cap ring. This thing doesn't hold this place, so clip is always loose. And every time I take this with me, it leaks on the cap. I have review on this pen. Actually, most of these pens, I will link if I have review in my channel. I made that series of like reviews of Fantomas for artists. But this one, I think that I should make updated review because I haven't been liking this at all. Also this has smell. And this cap thing like drives me crazy because it's, I don't like it. The quality is really bad. And then three pens that I will categorize as, they are not all the same brand, but I will show them inside by side because all of these pens are from China. And these are really cheap Chinese pens that I got from eBay. And this one is Hero something. Oh, it's a Hero 9018. It has Fude nib. It's not bent, it's meant to be like the Fude one. And this writes like, well, it has actually empty ink. And this writes like brush, which is really great for artists. It makes fine line when you hold this way and broader marks when you like hold it regularly. This has been really great pen, but it's also really heavy and ugly. It's full metal pen. But it was cheap. I think it cost under 3 euros, including shipping. And this one is Fountain pen from China that I don't even know the name, but it has clear feed. It's a so cool feed. And also it's green, so of course I had to get it. It has extra fine nib. This cost under 2 euros, I think 1 euro and 81 cents. It's piston filler. It hasn't leaked a bit. It has traveled with me in my backpack, and no leakage in the cap. No hard starts, writes well. It's not super smooth, I actually smoothed nib out a little bit, but it writes well, works well, doesn't leak, so that's perfect. Other Chinese pens that cost similar amount of money This has a fine nib because extra fine wasn't available. This has extra fine. And this pen, I really like it, the design of black, like, trims. And this has converter. I don't remember the brand. I think there wasn't even branding on these pens. Also, this one has, like, tendency to hard start. If I write, it's often stop writing suddenly. And when I start to write, if it, I have been, like, thinking moment and don't, like, writing actively, it's often dry out, so it's not that good of the pen. So, yeah, there was my modern fountain pens. I hope I didn't miss any. So, I have... Can they fit here? Almost. So, I have quite many. And... if I have to, like, pick my favorites, it would be this one. And Pilot 580 and VAC 700R. These are the pens actually I use the most. I'm sad that I can't, like, show the writing samples all of these pens because it would take a whole lot of time. But yeah, that's how many I have these modern fountain pens. And part 2 will be vintage. And I think I will post these three videos, like in series, they will come up like every day, just because I think it's clearer that way. So yeah, next up are the vintage fundamentals. Hope I see you in tomorrow's video. Bye!